Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Hedon. I actually did some reading on this game, and apparently its name is actually pronounced Hedon, which... I don't know how I feel about that. I'm probably just gonna keep calling it Hedon, because Hedon is applied directly to the forehead. Oh hey! That's a couple dudes. It was suggested that perhaps I start consuming some of my myriad consumables, but I don't know. What the fuck? Oh, we got new enemy types. We got some flyers in here. I love this thing, by the way. This crossbow is just the best thing ever. That's right. Gather up. Oh, hey. Oh, these things are pretty beefy. You need a direct hit. So are these like the Caco Demon equivalents then? Oh, and they have seeking rounds, at least to some small extent. Holy shit. Nice. Okay, things are getting a little dicey. Where's my Brobot? Brobot, go. Slay. There, I used a consumable. I used one, guys. Now I'll never speak of this again. I might use one of these here. That is still so fucking cool. Like, I just want to sit here and look at stuff. That is so fucking neat! Oh my lord. That's a lot of enemies, though. Which, like, I dig. Fuckers better leave my Brobot alone. Like this is a lot of dudes, but since it's like there's no hit scanners, there haven't been any hit scanners, so just running in circles is a viable strategy against like this kind of fight. And that's why like chain gunners in Doom, for example, are so scary, because you can't circle straight them. Because like once they lock onto you, you're just essentially taking damage. But with this, you know, I run in circles and I'm fine. But there was a dog in here somewhere. They might have friendly fired it down. Oh, hey, that's water. Oh, shit. Doink. Are we good? Is that... Oh, no, there's one left. I'm terrible. Oh, no, there's more. I have to say that I'm digging the music, though. It reminds me of something, and I can't place what, but it's good. Alright, well, that wasn't too bad. A little bit of an arena here. And that it goes completely silent is mildly terrifying. I shouldn't say terrifying, oh god, it's a good contrast from like being in combat and like, you know, running in circles, murdering everything, and high action to now it's just... All you hear is like the burning of the torches and stuff. That's pretty cool. That robot seemed pretty useful. I like it. This game, like, this is something that I could see them, like, I know it follows a main character. But something like this could be cool if they went like the Hexen route, where there's like multiple classes type thing. And either you pick a different class, or say you play a different character in like the next episode, whenever that comes out. And then like if there's a third episode, have a different character there. And then in like the fourth episode, if it's the final one, you're like, you get to pick which character you play. That could be interesting. Can I read this? Bathhouse of the Ancients, restored and preserved by Grand Earth Mother Briaza, probably. Alright, make sure our shit's reloaded. I should be using this thing more, I think. I'm not leveraging this gun as well as I probably should be. Healing? I suppose it doesn't matter because I'm at full health, but... Never know. corpse. Here. Map looks pretty normal, not seeing anything. This is giving me... This reminds me of something. I don't know what, though. More armor shards. Ammo. This wall remembers the western wing, which was damaged beyond repair. The recovered materials have been used to restore the other bath chambers. I punched through the wall. No. But... No, that's nothing. Alright. It looked like... When the map was zoomed out, it looks like there is perhaps a secret right here, but it's probably just this. It's probably... Yeah, it's pressed in just a little bit there. And with the, with how the line defs look when they're zoomed out, it looks gray instead of white for some reason. I'm just waiting. I'm waiting for the bullshit. It wouldn't surprise me if there wasn't any, because we just went through, like, a high-action thing in the courtyard there. But at the same time, no trust. That food. That note is not. I have no idea what it is. I can't eat it, so I don't care. Oh. Healing vial? I don't know if this is healing water. This might be healing water here. There's apparently another. There's apparently mushrooms. I didn't even see these things. Nice. A little bit of extra health. Oh, let's see. Oh. Oh. I mean, obvious secret is obvious, but still. I like it. Alright, so that's like something down there. Yeah. I want to finish exploring back this way before we go through whatever that happens to be. It might be the way that we're intended to go. Oh, seriously? Really? Oh, there we go. I was going to say, it's not going to let me clip through that? Apparently, we just had to walk at it with some motion and it was open. Alright, what do we have here? By the time it was discovered, this corridor had completely succumbed to ruin. The room behind has been reconstructed from bare rock by the Earth Mother's magic. Again, there's nothing there. Okay, this is healing water here for sure, because it's actually bubbling. Oh, wow, that is healing us fast, too, and it's actually healing us over cap a little ways. Neat! Alright, Alright, apparently there are... Like, come on, crouch. There are apparently multiple, like, tiers of healing water. Sure, I'll take it. Keeping an eye on our oxygen meter here. Are we on the other side? No. Oh no, this is something right here, but we can't open it. Or maybe they just forgot to have a line up on this side, I don't know. Alright, fair enough. Okay. Alright, so this leads to possible fiery burning. And this is a dead end, alright. This is why you don't go too far before you backtrack like a coward. Go ahead and save again. Is this... That's nothing. It's interesting how we've gone from, like, you know, a bathhouse to, like, what is looking more, like, industrial in nature. Like, working our way to the heating out. Yeah, I was just gonna say, working our way to the heating. Nice. The map design in this is really good. Holy crap, you guys. Ooh, that's interesting. The scroll feels warm, and after unrolling it, you notice the ink is still fresh. Zan, what the hell are you doing here? Weren't you supposed to be back off with our main force to strike the demons? Unless... Look, the demons are way up our ass right now. I saw you coming through the vision globe, and I think I know where you're headed. Cultists are all over the place, and pretty much everyone got ambushed and killed in moments. The Forge made no exception. An elven warlock seems to be leading this assault. Tough bitch, went straight through the lower plaza with some spell caving in the whole tunnel behind her. The Lancers won't hold out forever, and it's going to be hard for us to reach them and assist. Dura went through with five other orcs and used the Forge portal to get there. Or at least, I think so. The warp looked unstable to me. She told me to get to Beza, but I was too late, so I'm heading back to the Crystal Heart now. Hurry up to the Forge, I'll keep the portal open. Reaver tidy. Alright, what is this? There was loot game. I wasn't done. Let me reload. I think there was loot. I'm fairly certain there was loot. There may not have been loot, but I think I saw loot. Like, there wasn't loot, but there is this. Lore. The ledger holds the records of supplies brought in from the Forge. Several blank pages at the back seem to have been ripped away. Ha! Yeah, we did kind of go through there, didn't we? Maybe there is... Where is... Who the hell is this relative to anything? I have... Oh, okay, so this is the big storage room right on the other side over here. Okay, I know where we are. Interesting. I was gonna say, don't tell me I just locked myself in here. I would have been so salty. Looks like maybe... Oh, it's just the tunnel she came in up top, which I'm sure. Yeah, we can't go through that. All right, well, how'd we do? We got only two of the secrets. We killed everything, though. That's okay. And again, we actually, holy shit, I think it's a first for me in any of the Doom games we've played. I came in under par time. Holy shit. The half-orc hopped into the ventilation shaft. Sweaty arms shaking in exhaustion. As she crawled forward, she could feel her battered body less and less responsive, beckoning for rest. The air seemed to be growing hot. Visions of war rolled before her eyes, a dark citadel surrounded by hellish plains. Orcs were raging around her, clenched in battle with the demonic horde. She tried to move, but something held her in place, a dark figure with a gleaming pair of orange eyes. Aboath. The name suddenly rang her awake, head almost hitting against the narrow vent in surprise. How long had she been asleep? Moving forward, adrenaline coursing up her veins as the thought of the demon invasion brought her back on track. She had to reach the portal and use it to get to the Crystal Heart before the demons did. But with an army of cultists around, it won't be easy. It's good to know that I can just click to have this auto-reveal all the text. I'll probably be doing that in the future instead of just, like, slowing my reading. Okay, we're gonna save. Oh! Oh no, I can't close the door now! Get out of here. Jesus Christ. Where's my... your shits? Where'd my axe go? There it is. Where's my... night vision goggles is what I want. Ooh! Is that... Oh, you can pick up sentry with E and drop them. I mean, that's not what I wanted to do. I would like to pick it up into my inventory. The game is not letting me have nice things at the moment. Here you go, guy. Fuck shit up. Get them! I know they're in here somewhere. There you go. You believe in magic in a robot's heart. Oh, locked from the other side. Maximum disappointment. Anything? Aha! Holy shit, okay, it is really dark in here. Throw you down? Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm sure there's bullshit in here. Whoa, hey there. Oh! Just got winged. Oh, it appears that the robot does not have friendly fire. That's good. I can appreciate the lack of friendly fire. I'm curious if these things just persist until they die. It feels like that might be the case. Got some spikes. Again, I need to be using this thing more. Alright, so we have a tunnel there. Can I open this? Hmm. Do Switch is stuck. It seems to need the proper tools to unjam it without damaging it. Curse you, game. Oh, I can't set Robot down in here. Robot, I have to set you down out here for a moment. I'll be back for you, don't worry. I can't take the pressure anymore. First, the Forge Elemental suddenly tried to kill me for no reason, and now these giant hungry worms popped out of nowhere. Vika went out to inspect some odd noises, and the next thing I know, I'm running over her body towards the nearest hiding hole. Of course, I had no time to pick up my gun. Fire and iron, how we have angered you this time. Haven't we offered our best metal and flame to you? Maybe I can sneak by through the vents. I guess I'll have to leave my stuff here, then. Alright. Come here, Robot. That's right. You're my favorite little killing machine. Well, now... can I... There's something up here... No. Game, what do you want from me? I'm able to see the map. Oh, let's see. Well, this looks like it probably opens at some point. Like there's a shortcut. There might be something here. There, specifically. Maybe. Do we have... drop a hole? Can I kick it? No. Alright. Can I just open it with E? No. Alright. There are pipes here. Another little thing here that's really probably just, like, line depth being weird. Oh, that noise is... look at this. It's like freaking pitch darkness in here. Nothing there. Oh! I will take those armor shards. I do like how they converted, like, some, like, just standard Doom mechanics into, like, fantasy-themed Doom mechanics with, like, the armor crystals and stuff. Ah, okay, so here's something. I gotta go back for Brobot. Leave no bot behind. Come here. Is it still, like, heinously dark in here? Yes, yes it is. Alright, I'm glad that we have these night vision goggles. Oh. Nice. Oh! No! Oh, those worry me. Are those, like, is that gonna be our lost soul equivalent? Are they little, like, jolly suicide bombers? Why does it... let me try this again. Why does it default to this thing every time I drop this? I want it to default to my, like, babby tear gun, my little assault rifle. Now I know what all those little holes in the walls that I saw are. They're not actually line depths being weird. It's murder holes for killbots. Whatever the hell those things are supposed to be. Okay, so can we activate this now? Yeah, alright. Seriously? Seriously? Come on. What is that? Okay. Hey, we picked up a toolkit. We need that. John... this is like John Goblin or something. Again, it looks like just a little Easter egg back there. That's cute. Okay, another elemental ring. One of these days, I'll go back and rewatch the first episode so that I can figure out what button it is to get item tooltips. One day. Birth of the Earthborn, Chapter 7, The Pact. And now when they were forced to watch the ruins of their civilization, both the dwarves and the minotaurs understood that there was no more place for petty squirrels. I almost said squirrels. Only now were their eyes open as they were forced to gaze over the smoldering ruins of their once great hometowns. But alas, 'twas too late. The few who survived the demon invasion were scattered throughout Hedon's caverns, forced to live like scrawny nomads, struggling to survive day by day. No longer did they have the will to fight each other, knowing how the demons used the seed of subterfuge to divide and conquer them. The incompetent and corrupt leaders were already dead. It was time for the strong to take lead once more, and those new leaders had a great thirst for vengeance. great enough to forge an alliance with the ones they once despised. Now both dwarves and minotaurs stand by the same purpose, to fight the demons and rebuild their fallen prosperity. And here, the Iron Division orcs make them an offer. I couldn't help but see you struggle with the hurting the forge elementals by the lava pools. Take this magic ring. We dwarves use it to protect ourselves from the might of the fire. Perhaps you could take a stroll through the caverns tomorrow. I'll show you how to use it. Maybe stop by the tavern and have a drink, too. I will wait for you by the forge, Thorvald. Alright, so well, based on that at least... Can I open this ring here? I can. Well, it did say it was locked from the inside, I suppose. Knowing that now, though... I suppose we can infer that the elemental ring probably just gives us, like, fire resistance or something. Nice! Fuck off, hellhounds! I got a murder bot! Man, I should just lob a fucking crush bow bolt into this. But those things are precious. Alright, murder bot, get in there. Make sure that it's clear while I loot the bodies. I think that's everything. Alright. He can just camp there for- Oh, hey! It's our bro! You see Tidy on the other side of the window. She nods at you, but doesn't look very relieved to see you. A finger trace message lies on the reinforced glass. Locked me in, through key, portal running out, hurry. That is totally like a fucking Quake portal over there, too. We need a key. Oh, does that mean that we're gonna have to leave her behind? That's... saddening. And we're gonna be able to... Alright. No. Aha! Oh my. This is a giant mancubus kill chamber if I've ever seen one. Although I'm sure it's gonna be those fire floating things, which maybe are fire elementals. Oh no, I assume that's a fire elemental. Okay. Robot, where are you? Come to me! Can you get... fuck your shit up. We had two robots, now we're down to one. Shit's fucking exploding everywhere. Alright. Interesting. That's a unique take. You don't have a mold. Oh, we're gonna have to forge something. Pick up some dark vision goggles. I think there's like a little bit of music playing in here, and it very much is reminding me of like Terminator 2, the theme from Terminator 2. It might actually just be mechanical sounds, I don't know. Alright, we're gonna save, do stupid suicidal things like we do. Is this? That is nothing. Oh god. Can we step on this? Yes, but it hurts us, okay. Good to know, we have pain sectors. We get up here, not quite. Although there's something up there and it looks like a new gun. So we'll probably have to lower this maybe. Oh, and they're giving me some healing because they know some people are just gonna be idiots and step into fiery burning. Oh, I don't like this. Okay, so this is how we get back up there, then. Yeah, I think those things are like the Lost Souls, except they're suicide bombers instead of little chompy boys. You recover a burnt fragment of scroll. Most of the text has been ruined. Don't harvest red crystal clusters. Only the single one didn't explode when pulled on. Yeah, that's them telling me that these things explode. I remember that. What is this? A skin of spring water, sure. Gun. Chain. Lever? Something happened. I hear sounds of violence. Nope! Oh, those things! Oh my god, my aim is so bad. There was a time when my Twitch aim was really good. Now it's just mostly garbage. Ow. They literally spit fireballs. That's so cool. Oh, smart enough to open door. God damn it. Oh, they're worse. They're worse than Lost Souls because they deal so fucking much damage. 4 health. Healing. Yes, I do. Go ahead and save again. Oh, fuck you, reload. There's some healing laying about in here, which I am thankful for. Take our axe back. Oh, apparently there were some shield bearers in here. I didn't even notice them. They might have been already dead. Okay, what is this? To the Dwarven Forge. The big room. No. Oh, no, not the axe. Oh, my lord. Ah, yes, let's melee the thing that explodes when we kill it. Tongs just hang on a chain. I don't even know. It will be long until we return from the war against the demons, but as always, you have to learn the reins of patience, my son. You've been fulfilling your apprenticeship well, so I will allow you to finally reach beyond our old ways of smelting. Alas, you may finally use the smelting machine to make precise iron bars. Drop the iron arm into the red-hot hearth and marvel as it melts and drips into the shape of an ingot. Don't forsake your duty and do not envy mine. Your task here is as difficult as fighting a horde of foul beasts, and I trust that you'll stand up to our name. Stone be with you. Okay, so... Yeah, so we're apparently gonna need an ingot for something. It's so weird, all the tools are just hanging on chains. I don't know. I don't know what they're going for there. That isn't just, like, tool hanging on chain. Workshop. La, is this the main chamber? Parabane, no. Ooh. Dead fire elemental. Dead orc. More things. Alright, so here's where we're gonna have to bring our ingot. An iron key mold machine. Insert an ingot into the hearth and close the hatch. Once the right hatch is opened, remove the key from the mold. I finally repaired the key machine. Tell the mentors to come haul it back to the mold forge. This thing makes so much noise I can't hear my own thoughts. I like it. A little broken minecart there. Hey, another sentry gun. I'll take it. Some stupid iron urchin wandered into one of the testing caves yesterday, and the sentry started shooting at it. Little fucker didn't shy around and charged right at it, blowing it up to bits. As you can see, the sentry's messed up, but I reckon you can fix the hull. I'll handle its brain once you're done here. Clearly, I need to talk to the Lancers, since it seems they forgot to program the damn thing to not shoot at our own maintenance drones. Anyway, I've dropped you a working sentry for reference. Remember that once you deploy it, you'll need the right tools to unpack it, or it will self-destruct. Call me for help, B. Alright, so the little floating suicide bombers are apparently called iron urchins. And they are repair drones of some sort. Oh, here's the main room. I'm gonna... How the fuck? Stupid. But what is this thing? It's a dead orc. That's a lump of iron ore. It's not a gun. It's decidedly not a gun, and my disappointment is immeasurable. Is this the smelt room? Do that. Yeah, okay. Let's smelt an iron ore with some lava. Very dwarf fortress. And we come in here and we put the ingot in there. This is so Hexen 2! Like, holy shit. Now we have a key. I'm a genius. I can do basic problem solving in video games. Hey, was it this door that was locked? Ooh, drawbridge control. We haven't actually been in here. Oh no, yeah we have. We came from here. Alright, cool. Oh, okay. Alright. So when we hit that switch in there, I didn't even realize that this was open. It apparently opened this and dropped all the bridges. Neat. Alright, that is the earth key. Earth key. Old forge, and there's the workshop. Where do we need? Let's zoom out a little bit here. Where do I need the iron key? Okay. Opposite side here. What's up, robot? Come on. We got things to do. Oh, you didn't! Oh, the portal's gone. Oh, she probably left. That would make sense. She couldn't wait any longer. Left me ammo. You notice a scroll of parchment right by the portal. Tidy's writing style is already familiar to you. portal gate's fading out, so I really have to go. I'm not sure if you'll get here anytime soon, but if you read this, know that your only hope to reach the crystal heart now lies inside the grove. The portal there should still be functional, since it had a stronger power source. However, I think you have also noticed the pack gate leading to it got sabotaged by the cultists back in the plaza. The main gear that was operating the gate mechanism was broken. You'll have to search around for spare parts. Head to the workshop. There has to be some information about what kind of gear you need to replace, or at least how to craft it. Take this key and a couple spare mags I had. You'll need them. Alright, so yeah, she left me some goodies. Kind of her. Gonna fuck this shit in here. It'll probably be days before the portal recharges enough power to activate again. Oh, she actually left me a message. Tidy's gone, it looks like you're too late and the portal is closed. A new message lies on the glass, written in strange dark marks. Oddly enough, you can read it. You will follow me, you will remember me. Mildly creepy. Because those marks weren't there when I first, like, zipped in here and saw that thing on the other side of the glass, so that must have appeared, like, when I came through. That's pretty cool. This game is doing some really nifty things with the Doom engine, I have to say. But I never actually tried this door. Can we open this? No. These, yeah, they do. Oh, hey. Apparently pissed something off. Okay, we actually still haven't been down there either. Too much to explore. Alright, so we're gonna leave the robot here, and I think I'm going to go ahead and save and call it an episode. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you all had a good time, and I will see you all next time, wherein violence continues. Until then.